The Cavaliers are out of Cleveland as they take on their Eastern Conference rival in tonight's contest. The fans making some noise here at the Knicks Arena. The New York Knicks are getting settled in. You're in for a treat as we bring you NBA basketball on 2K Sports. With Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and our sideline reporter, Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan. And so off the tip, it's New York. Here's the starting group for the Cleveland Cavaliers. LeBron and Love are the talented pair at the forward position. Kyrie Irving and J.R. Smith are the guard set. And it's Thompson in at the five down low. And it's good! Porzingis has got the opening field goal of the game for the Knicks.
And those are the first points of the game.
Nice hoop to get the scoring started there.
And guys, Porzingis was almost a rookie last season, but he opted to pull out of the early entry and wait a year for this past summer's draft. Seems to have worked out for him as far as how his draft stock has changed.
Here's Rose, following the basket by Kevin Love. Lee passes to Porzingis. Plays it up and in on the nice reverse. Porzingis has got his second basket.
I like it. I like it. He broke out the fancy finish there.
They set the pick. Smith against Lee. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. Guys, just watching Kevin Love, he brings so much to the table. But if you had to pick one thing, Clark, it might be the rebound.
I agree with you. I mean, he's not super athletic, doesn't blow you out of the water with his athleticism. But a few seasons back, this guy averaged 15 rebounds a game.
And he makes the first.
And guys, you look at what makes Love such a prolific rebounder. Great anticipation. I mean, he has the broad shoulders to create space in the paint, the strong anchor to hold his position. It's no wonder he's been a dominating force on the glass at every level since high school.
And that one goes in, two from the line that time.
You know, regarding Kevin Love, he had a number of difficult transitions to make last season. Most of all, perhaps on the offensive glass, he averaged less than two a game after averaging three or more a game every other season.
He muscles it in through the contact, and they call the foul. And he's on his way to the free throw line.
And when the size advantage is as big as it was there, I mean, that's exactly what he's supposed to do in that situation.
The Knicks shooting their first free throw attempt on the night.
And how about as a group, 80% on the season, one of their best attributes.
Yeah, in general, they've been very solid. I mean, free throw shooting isn't something they've had to worry about too much this season, guys.
That free throw good from Porzingis.
I mean, the Knicks were bad last year, and it became evident early on as the season grew older. More and more of their national coverage games were being pulled.
Now, here's James. Love outside. The three-pointer, no good.
Boy, even though he missed, you can't give up that kind of a look very often.
It's better to be lucky than good sometimes. Fortunately, they didn't get burned on that one.
Porzingis, and a rebound goes to the Cavaliers. For the Knicks, losing a lot of nationally televised games, too. It seemed like every time they were on, they were losing. It might have been a blessing in disguise.
Well, I hope they look at it in a positive vein. It did give them a chance to focus on player development there in New York. Also allowed them to shut down Melo for the season.
Here's Rose, following the basket by Kyrie Irving. It's Anthony with the drive. Great D that time from Love.
Those are chances. Almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points, but the D, just enough to keep him out of rhythm.
Now, here is Smith. Pass to James. Thompson right side. Just five to shoot. So they take the lead. Irving's got five now.
I tell you what, guys, it's going to be a tough day on this defense if he's got the A game rolling tonight.
Here's Porzingis. And again, it's the Knicks missing.
Well, I think the defense got lucky right there. I mean, he's going to make a lot more of those than he misses when he's got that much room.
Outside Irving to the inside. Here's Love. Yes, and it's Irving picking up the assist. And that's now 6 points for Kevin Love. Anthony, the pass to Porzingis. He feeds it to Rose. Lee outside. Noah with a screen on Smith. Lee kicks it to Noah. And he can't stop the run as he misses. The Cavaliers leading by 4. Clark, this offense has really been clicking.
No doubt about it, giving the defense all kinds of trouble.
And they know it, guys. They're playing right now with the kind of energy that is hard to deal with.
Now here's Anthony. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Rose attacking, stolen by Thompson. Here's Irving. Passes to Smith. James, left side. Kicks it to Thompson. LeBron against Anthony. The pass to Rose. Lee outside. Just 5 on the clock. New York needs to get off a shot. New York, no good that time either.
And how big was last year's trade for J.R. Smith? I mean, sent from the Knicks to the Cavaliers around midseason, Smith began to post some of the better numbers of his career, helping prove that for a tumultuous personality like Smith's, environment is key.
An entire new group. Boomer, he's checked in for Noah. Kyle O'Quinn comes in for Porzingis. Justin Holliday's checked in for Lee. And it's Jennings in for Rose. A minute 20 left here in the opening quarter. Shot to stop the drought. And the foul on Kyle O'Quinn. That is his first foul of the game.
You know, the defense has got to do a much better job of fighting over those screens.
And, Greg, especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know he doesn't miss too many open looks like that.
Shumpert with it. 105 left in the first quarter. Williams with the ball, and Jennings picks him up defensively. 4 on the shot clock. Here's LeBron, and that one goes long. Knicks trail by 4. Anthony left side. Shoots the 3. It's rebounded by Cleveland. They can go 2 for 1.
It's about being smart right now.
Here's James, and O'Quinn sends it back. And that'll be Cleveland as it goes out of bounds. Cavaliers retain possession. ...32 seconds left in the first. Here's Shumpert. Hits the front of the rim and out.
The defense did a really good job of choking off the middle there once he got inside.
Jennings kicks to Anthony. The shot's good. Jennings making the play. Anthony's got 5.
And if you're the guy who has to guard him, it is never going to be an easy night for you.
It's stolen by Anthony. with one on the clock. No good on the buzzer beater. A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. Cavaliers lead by one. And we've got more NBA action on 2K Sports coming your way after this break. A chance to hear from LeBron James as he talked about the challenge of remaining calm and collected throughout the ups and downs of the NBA season. Again, just another part of the maturation process for LeBron. He's become such the consummate pro.
Yeah, he really has been. It's amazing to see the pressure he's dealt with and the way he's handled it with that even-keeled nature. You know, he's a solid and steady as they come at this point in his career. Nothing phases him, nothing rattles him.
And the second quarter getting underway. No team gaining an edge so far. And from what you guys have seen so far from Cleveland, what's your take?
Right from the start, they have been able to really own that paint and just dominate the backboard.
Well, Greg, you can't dominate the boards unless all five guys are making the effort to box out and chase down the ball.
They've got Jennings. Kyle Quinn out there with Boomer. Then it's Lee, and it's Holiday in at the small forward. So that's who's on the floor for the Knicks. Now here's Williams. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Shumpert, no good.
The defense there got away with a major lapse. And one problem with the Cavs last season was they put immediate pressure on themselves. A part of that was the trade for Kevin Love.
They're going back to the three-point shot over and over and over.
And they may have found the Achilles heel of this defense. That was their ninth straight point from beyond the arc.
No good from Fry. As you said, the Cavs put a lot of pressure on themselves because of the trade. You could see it affect the way they came out of the gate, Clark.
And, you know, it was just night and day, Kevin, when the Cavs began to relax and click. I mean, a total transformation and turnaround. They would go 19-20 in the first 39 games and then 34-9 over the rest of the season once those guys gelled and got locked in.
Okay, time now for an injury report. We'll get a chance now to check up on Carmelo Anthony's status. Doris?
Guys, I had a moment to catch up with the Knicks head athletic trainer. Not what we wanted to hear, guys. It sounds like it's a very serious injury.
Okay, Doris, sounds like he won't be out for too long.
Well, hopefully that's the case, Kevin, and he'll be back before long.
Now here's Shumpert. James with it, and Holiday picks him up defensively. Outside Shumpert. Here's Love, and the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Love. Zinkus, he's checked in for Boomer. Smith checked in for Cleveland. Kyrie Irving comes in for Mo Williams. Here's Jennings. Outside Holiday. It's back to Jennings. There's the screen. Down to five on the shot clock. Here's Porzingis. New York, no good that time either. The Cavaliers trail by five.
You know, Channing Frye signed a four-year, $32 million contract in 2014. And in the very first leg of that contract, promptly had his worst season in 5 years. In fact, he even lost his starting job along the way.
Now, here is Irving. 7 points in the game. This is to Shumpert. A steal. Here's Porzingis, covered by Smith. Jennings kicks to Holiday. There's the pick. Lee outside. Down to five on the shot clock. Smith dishes to Fry. and a wide open look for Irving. Nailed from three-point land. Irving's got 10 points.
A wide open three. They need much better communication defensively.
Joakim Noah has checked in for Kyle O'Quinn. Anthony comes in for Lee. And it's Rose in for Brandon Jennings. And it's the Knicks with the ball. In the second quarter, they've given up just 3 points. Anthony down low, guarded by Shumpert. And a great move from Anthony as he gets it to go. Anthony's got 7 points in the game.
And that's what the pump fake's there for. Get your man off his feet and drive right around him. In that one spot the Cavs did struggle with last year was help off the bench. They were last in the league in bench scoring. How about the way he's able to angle his body to shield the big fella off and still get the finish?
You've got to be clever with your sleight of hand when you get inside and try to finish against the bigger guys. He made it. He made it look easy that time.
Cavaliers making a switch here. James has checked in. And let's get your take, guys, on the hustle stats for the Knicks.
Boy, they've really amped up the pressure at the defensive end, guys, and have piled up the steals in the early going.
And also, how about how well they defended the rim? Not just blocking shots, but also altering them here in this first quarter. Oh, wow.
That's a beautiful jam.
And, guys, that's a big swing right there. I mean, taking the steal and then turning it into two easy points on the dunk.
No telling how important that sequence could turn out to be.
And, guys, in a game this snug, moments like that are the ones we usually look back on at the end as a difference maker.
And that was Kia bringing you the close-up on the big-time play. Here's Irving. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time. And it's a three-point Cavalier lead.
He's a big reason why they have the lead right now. He's made all of his field goal attempts thus far and remains hot from the floor.
Rose attacking. And off the front, and in it goes. Rose has got his first bucket of the night.
And that's why it's so important to really be a good screening team. You get a lot of open looks from it.
Outside jumping. To the paint and foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. That one on Rose. Well, what a season for Kyrie Irving last year. Huge moments for him. 57-point outburst against San Antonio. That was a new franchise record for the Cavs.
I think a lot of it was finally being able to play with other all-stars, quite honestly, Kevin, but you can't discount the work Irving put into the offseason to be ready for the regular season.
First one falls for him.
And for Irving, he did come into last year hot. I mean, he won the MVP in international play while with Team USA.
Williams, he's checked in for Shumpert. Both free throws, good for Irving.
And for Kyrie, taking home the MVP in a Team USA tourney like that, it's a huge ego boost. I mean, of all the stars on that team, he shined the brightest. And I think that's going to help his confidence for this year.
6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. puts it up from 12. It's good, the assist that time from Smith. Smith's got three assists now in this one. Rose up on top. He's covered by Irving. Rose against Irving. Good on that shot. And with that, the Cavalier lead is cut down now to just three in the basket from Derrick Rose. James outside. And released it in time, but it's off the mark. And we're through the first half of basketball here in what's been a good one. Cavaliers on top as they wrap up the second quarter on a 14-6 run. And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
No, Carmelo, after this first half of play, what do you believe the team needs to focus on from here on out?
Well, just communication and trusting one another. When somebody get beat, the next guy got his back, and we're just trying to get up and down, get going some way, somehow. For the most part, we did pretty good. A couple of adjustments on the defensive end. Make some shots, and we'll be fine.
Melo, thanks for the time. Guys, over to you.
Thank you so much, Doris. Great interview as always. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be back with the second half of basketball shortly.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back, everybody. It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show. Ernie Johnson along with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. What a game it's been for Kyrie Irving. He ended up with 19 points, 2 assists, and 1 rebound. Kenny, your thoughts. How are the Cavaliers playing?
Well, they didn't let this hostile crowd bother them at all. In fact, they seem to feed off of that hostility. Plus, sometimes when you're away from home, those distractions, your family, your friends, your fans, you can concentrate better. Okay, wait, did I just say my family, friends, and fans are distractions? Okay, let's go to the next thing. Let's go.
Check. What did you think about New York?
Well, they need to be much more aggressive on offense. Try to get to the foul line more. It's called a charity stripe for a reason. They haven't shown they want it, Ernie. Everybody wants charity. Me too. I like charity. They don't get more aggressive, they might have a hard time in the second half.
And that'll do it for now as the second half of our game is about to get underway. Kevin Harlan has the call.
The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. You look at Kyrie Irving in this game, he has been everywhere.
And the thing I noticed most in that first half was his offense. He was not wasteful with his opportunities and also did a great job of converting with the chances he had.
I agree with you, Greg. Judicious shot selection. All of his looks were good looks.
The Cavaliers leading by 3. So on the floor for Cleveland, J.R. Smith and LeBron at the 2 and 3. Thompson is out there with Kevin Love, and it's Irving in at the 1 spot. On the wing, James. There's the 3. Here's Thompson, and it's blocked. But they recover it. Love kicks to Irving. And a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in. Irving's got the first points to start out the third quarter for the Cavs. Well, last season would be one where Kevin Love played a different role, saw his numbers decline, but that was, I think, especially with LeBron and Kyrie, much better players than he ever had in Minnesota. that was to be expected.
It's a great point, Kevin. And Love dropped about 10 points per game in terms of his output. The field goal percentage as well as three-point percentage was down. But still, he traded it all to be on a winning team. And I really feel like his numbers will start to go up as he makes the adjustment to playing with great players.
Good point.
And, you know, for Love last season, we knew he'd be in a supporting role to LeBron. You put any player next to LeBron, and he automatically becomes some kind of role player.
Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good.
And thinking back to Love and his numbers last year, we saw the same thing from Bosch when he played with LeBron. Love and Bosch had similar reductions in scoring, but both were still great players, and they both have the ability to adapt and impact the game in other ways.
Both free throws good from Anthony. Carmelo Anthony, the third pick overall in the 2003 NBA draft, was in some pretty good company at the top of that one, as I recall.
I mean, you had LeBron going one, and of course, Darko Milicic was number two on that list. But how about D-Wade at four? A little bit of a surprise, Chris Bosh. You know, all those guys, with the exception of Melo, have rings.
Mm-hmm. Uses both hands to slam it down.
And that's how it's done. I mean, find that hole in the D and then go hard to the rack.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
Well, it was. I mean, a tight game like this one, you think they'd have a little more energy at the defensive end than that. And back to Melo's top five draft mates in 2003, all having rings. You can't choose the team you play for as a rookie. Melo simply hasn't been surrounded by that much talent. That's why it was somewhat surprising that he re-signed with the rebuilding Knicks team last season.
Quarter of basketball, about a minute and a half in. Irving for three. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time. Smith's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight.
And guys, talking about Melo, I mean, he's faced some difficult injuries here of late. That puts all the more pressure on him to win a ring as soon as possible. No way does he want to retire without that chance.
Inside, just five to shoot, and he gets the bucket. Porzingis has got nine.
Just a major size difference between the defender and shooter on that possession.
And Greg, without a hand in his face, he's simply going to spray whoever's there.
Rose with the ball. Now Smith defending. Lee against James. Here's Porzingis. It's good. This game is all even. Porzingis has got four this quarter.
You know, of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is major smash-mouth basketball, guys.
It's all about imposing your will offensively, getting exactly the kind of looks their coach drew up.
To the paint, wants to get it off to Noah and does. For the lead. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
And you look at Joakim Noah, I mean, one of those hybrid talents. As a center, he gives you the rebounding, the shot blocking you want. But then he also has tremendous passing skills and instincts and the energy of a mountain lion.
And going back to Joakim Noah, he really is a hybrid. He holds American, Swedish, and French citizenships. He's truly a man of the world, and he's worldly on the floor. He can guard and play a lot of different positions.
And Kevin, he looks like a man of the world. He has a unique style unto himself, but I'll take the versatility and the hustle he brings on my team any day. If he's healthy, he's a factor.
Kyle O'Quinn is checked in for the Knicks. Jennings comes in for Derrick Rose. So he picks up just one from the line that time. And last year, not exactly up to Noah's lofty standards. is way down in field goal percentage and free throw percentages compared to the season before, but he did not play completely healthy all of last year either.
A little dinged up, missed 13 games more than he had the season prior, and also the minutes dropped as well. And you could just see him laboring at times on the floor, clearly affected by those injuries.
And it's Lee penetrating. New York, no good that time either. Cleveland's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. No one near James as he lets it go. Cans the shot from the wing. LeBron's got his second bucket of the game to go.
And, you know, going back to Noah last season, I think the additions to the Bulls' front court had an effect on him. I mean, they added Gasol and Mirotic, two major talents up front. I think that gave Noah less opportunities than he'd had the year before, and it was an adjustment for him.
Boomer, he's checked in for New York. Justin Holiday comes in for Lee. And Cleveland also making a change. Williams, he's checked in for Kyrie Irving. Outside Williams. LeBron outside. Pass to Fry. It's picked off. Now here's Anthony. He's got 11. Tries to keep it alive. And now the fast break. LeBron with the ball. Pulls up. The rebound by Holiday.
This shot's just, it's not there right now. With his team leading, perhaps, you know, let's focus on some other areas of the game. And guys, talking about Joakim Noah, he was still the spirit of that team last season. Amongst all the great talents the Bulls had, Noah was that energizer and catalyst for the team. A true warrior, even in an off year.
Outside Williams. Feeds to Love. Back to Williams. It's a pick by Love. Clock at six. Williams attacking. The shot no good. And New York will come the other way. Jennings kicks to Anthony. Out to the right wing. Fader on the way. That's short off the rim. The Cavaliers trailing. Love with the screen on Anthony. And Shumpert kicks to Love. And here is Anthony. Outside Jennings. The dish now to O'Quinn. Pass to Boomer. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. Knicks last season had a lot of problems here in Manhattan, and it showed all over the floor, Greg. And you played for this team. You know what it's like to play basketball in New York. Not a good record for them at home last year.
How about finishing 10-31 here and playing in front of a sold-out crowd every night? And one thing about New York, they're going to let you know when they're displeased. Worst home record in the East and second worst home record in the league.
That free throw, no good.
And, you know, for the Knicks, there were a lot of reasons why they were bad at home. Bottom five in field goal percentage, against at home field goal defense, and third worst field goal percentage at home in the league.
Catching up on the changes for Cleveland. Tristan Thompson comes in for Kevin Love. And Smith subbed in for James. And he's good on the second.
And, you know, commend the Knicks faithful. They still would sell this place out. And you have to give a shout-out to the fans for sticking through what was a very difficult year. At least it has to get better. You can't afford to give him that kind of a look.
Well, you know, he came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you've got to do a better job of fighting over and through that.
Outside Jennings. Sweet little floater. Jennings has got 4 points now in the quarter.
And it's all about the release when you shoot the floater.
And we just finished the third quarter, and we've got a tight ball game here. New York ahead, up by two. And after a quick break, we're going to come right back with the start of the fourth quarter. We've got a great game on our hands as we welcome you back. The fourth quarter of action getting started. New York's gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. Lee out there with Rose. Then it's Anthony. Then there's Noah. And it's Porzingis in at the four spot. That's the five for New York right now. And he gets it to go. Porzingis has got the fourth quarter going with the first basket of the period here for the Knicks. Rose against Irving. Stolen by Rose. Let's it go from 11. Oh, and that one had the right spin on it, and it is good. And the Knicks lead by 6. And a closer look here at the hustle stats for the Knicks.
The activity level defensively, I've really been impressed with. There's been an attack mode on the defensive end.
You know, adding on to that, you look at their block totals tonight, and you see how feisty they've been on the defensive end this game.
Porzingis passes to Lee.
And guys, Courtney Lee now having completed 7 full seasons, very much the same guy now as he was entering the league. A 3-and-D prototype who will most likely never be a plus playmaker.
That free throw, no good.
And they're drawing more whistles and working their way to the line here in the second half.
And guys, I think it's exactly the right thing to do with the lead. Keep going at defenders and find a way to get yourself to the line.
Kevin Love's checked in for Cleveland. LeBron comes in for Shumpert.
And even with one miss, he's still able to stretch that to a 2-possession game. That is huge for them right now.
The feed now to Love. Joakim Noah grabs the miss. Talking about Courtney Lee, you know the ball handling and court vision are suspect, but you know you don't care because he's provided solid defense on the wing, Clark, and he's hit over 40% of his threes last year.
And he's also one of the best free throw shooting two guards in the league, Kevin. And last year he and Conley were out of sight at the end of games. That's a wonderful combo to have, two great free throw shooting guards late.
Irving double team, and Love throws it down.
How about that fantastic finish and the aggressive move, too, Kevin?
Trying to send a message, Clark, with that slam, I think.
And I'm not sure if it was text or email, but he definitely threw that one down.
Anthony kicks to Rose. Noah with a screen on Love. Shot clock at 5. Here's Porzingis. Will not go. This is off the front iron. Cavaliers have gone 2-of-3 from the field to get the fourth quarter started. LeBron James on the wing, covered by Lee. Oh, wide open look for Love. Yes, and it's LeBron picking up the assist. 11 points for Kevin Love. It's been a tight one so far. Very close game.
Well, 7 lead changes, Kevin, in this one, and we could very well be seeing more.
And matchups, it's really what it's all about, and these two teams are really equal.
No good from Lee.
The game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding has been the one differentiator thus far.
And Greg, we've seen it time and time again in games. Effort and determination on the glass can make up for a lot of other weaknesses.
Here's the screen. Rose against Irving. Now Rose. Passes it to Porzingis. Knocks down the three ball. Porzingis has got it all tied up now for the Knicks.
Defenders need to recognize and be alert to staying on him as we get into crunch time.
All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
Thanks, guys. I got a chance to hear what Cleveland's head coach was saying to his team. He told them, the game is right there for the taking, fellas, but we've got to be first. First to loose balls, first to the rim. We have to give our all right here. Kevin, now's the time.
Huge.
bucket to take the lead on one of his patented finishes there. Just a couple more of those, and they'll be in the driver's seat as this game goes down the stretch.
Let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for Cleveland.
Boy, their passing has been picturesque, a thing of beauty in both halves. More than a few of their baskets have come off assists.
Yeah, but they also never seem to get cold from mid-range. Just kept hitting those shots with consistency. Wow, wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
Blatant contact. Straightforward call. Simple.
Free throw good, LeBron. No good on the second free throw. Knicks trail by three. And there's the pass to Porzingis. Anthony left side. Pass to Porzingis. Shot clock at six. Floats one up. No good. Good D by Irving. Cleveland with the ball. They're on a 13-4 run right now. He kicks to Smith. He dishes it to Love. Back to Smith. And Tristan Thompson gets the whistle that time. And that'll be his third foul so far.
Seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
And that's because the ball is looking for the best shot, and it's really paid off for them during the run.
Kyrie Irving really making a difference here.
He's in one heck of a groove with the scoring. They're going to talk it over and try to figure out how to slow him down.
.157 left in the fourth quarter. That is good.
And that's an owner's manual possession to get them a good look there, Kevin.
There's .154 left in the fourth. The Knicks pull it in. Noah's got three rebounds so far in the game. Rose up on top. He's covered by Irving. Rose dishes to Carmelo. And it's LeBron James with the rebound.
Oh, he knows that one should have gone in. That hurts.
And yes, sir, that one drops.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Well, when you look at the assist totals, heck, they've been clearly the better team.
.127 left in the game. Rose against Irving. Noah in the post. And Thompson sends it back. They get it back. Smith drives in. James. Good D by Lee. Knicks trail by five. He feeds it to Rose. Off the pick. Good. What a beautiful shot to bring him to within three.
Clutch basket, even with him being on the short end of the stick, size-wise.
Really, Greg, just shows you the toughness and determination this man has. Impressive.
LeBron passes to Thompson. Just five on the clock. Here's Love. Can't hit. Now the Knicks take it the other way.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job.
And it's Lee penetrating. To the middle, 11 feet away. Connects! And that shot brings them to within just one.
clutch shot right there. That could be the difference maker.
Indeed, it might be a big, huge moment in this game right there.
Yeah, you can't let them hold the ball and just milk those last seconds away.
No, you got a foul. I mean, it's going to come down to free throws here. Foul right away.
And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a three-point game.
Those were pressure-packed free throws. And he looked as cool as he could be. So big to give them that three-point lead.
Here's Lee. Shot is off. Smith with some nice D. And now they foul and stop the clock.
You have to foul, but I'm sure they would have liked to foul someone different.
Yeah, but Greg, they didn't really have another option. I mean, I thought they did a nice job getting it in his hands and making sure he was the guy who'd go to the line.
And the second free throw, no good. A tough break there. And a wide open look for Lee. It's good! And what a sensational bucket to bring them within one.
That's how to orchestrate for your teammate. Terrific pass.
They're going to prolong the game here with an intentional foul. It's good on the first, and that will put them up by two. And so both free throws are good, and it's a three-point game. Rose. Oh, he couldn't make that shot go to force overtime. So it's a narrow win for the Cavaliers, pulling it out. This win, such a tremendous emotional boost for him.
Really an accomplishment and crazy finish to take a road game like this and simply deflate an entire building.
And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Yes, I'm here with Kevin Love. And Kevin, a very big effort to come away with this game. What does it mean to the resiliency of this team to pull out a win like this?
We're just giving ourselves a chance to win. So, I mean, we're really just grinding it out as much as we possibly can. We're getting better every day. So, we're happy we got this win. I got to give it all to my teammates and my coaches.
Hard work pays off, Kevin. Great job. Guys, back to you.
Doris, thank you as always. And that about wraps it up. This is Kevin Harlan saying thank you for tuning in. We'll see you next time. Have a great evening.
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
Hi again, everybody. This is Ernie Johnson, joined by Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Time now to present our Jordan Player of the Game, Kyrie Irving. He notched his season high, and his scoring really seemed to set the tempo for his team tonight.
He accounted for more than half of their points, an amazing output. When there was a bucket they absolutely had to have, he was the guy they went to. Now, that's an awful lot for one player, but he did not let them down.
I don't know what got into him tonight. Whew. He caught the scoring bug and was just pouring it in the paint. That's the kind of offense he's capable of delivering when he sets his mind to it.
And that'll do it for our broadcast tonight. Hope you enjoyed the show. For me and Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, and Kevin Harlan, and the entire 2K Sports crew, have a wonderful evening.